Wow.
Good morning, everybody. Sorry, I'm a few minutes late getting everything ready here. The coffee and... Hey, Claudia. Keisha and Nancy. Ken, Dr. Menz. Nancy. Hey, Adam. All right. Good to see you could make time, Adam. Sounds like you're working really hard these days. Hey, John. Happy Sunday to you. Hey, Dave. Mike. Big week. New DBT logo. The Crucial Taunt logo just came in. We'll talk more about that in a minute. This is the 10 Years Gone episode. All things Jimmy Page. Hey, Steve. And I'm going to play acoustic Jimmy Page stuff. And Jimmy Page inspired stuff. Hey, BTR. Terry Lynn. Yeah, that was my niece who did the logo. David Barrett Trio. DB Tribe. Hey, Jim. keep playing on Robert Plant's up there. It was Robert Plant, Jimmy Page did the solo on Sea of Love, and Jeff Beck did the solo on Good Rockin' Tonight. Thank you. David Lannerman had the Honey Drippers on with Brian Setzer on guitar. And that was awesome. It's probably on YouTube. Happened to be in the right tuning for Saltwater, so we can tie that in somehow to the Jimmy Page set, because I think Arizona Michelle asked for that last time and it wasn't in the right tuning, it wasn't even close. So let me see. Played this on 12 string. Thank you. Oh, God. You put it on 12 strings and it messes me up. And combined with the pick. Wow, I'm going to move on. Nice try. I'll pick it up another day.
What are you going to do?
You win some, you lose some, you know? Maybe at the end of the show I'll do it on classical like I normally play it, and it won't freak me out. So I'm going to continue on with the set. Yeah, it's just a thing, you know. What can I tell you? It's like you combine playing with a pick on a different guitar with 12 strings, and then you're out of your comfort zone, and that whole memory thing just kind of closes in on you, you know? We'll be right back. Okay, that's the 12-string segment of the program. And just getting over the whole saltwater incident now. I'm bouncing back. Now this is a this goes back to a record 2006 or 2007 where I did a little tribute song to a bunch of different guitar players, and one of them is called Zoso, and I'm going to play it for you now. It's a short little tune on the loud. Kind of sounds a little Zeppelin 3-ish, you know? Yeah, that kind of reminded me of that kind of acoustic Zeppelin phase. And as influential as they were to all the hard rock, there was a whole other type of acoustic rock thing that they were kind of doing alongside of Crosby, Stills, and Nash around the same time. Good idea, Nancy. I like that, the little skull necklace on the bear, eh? And then we did Sonar. But there's certainly Zeppelin feel. That's right, Shake Your Tree, that's a great track. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was Sonar from the first DB3 record. I think Big Al liked that one because of the kind of cool little modal Jimmy Page stuff in there. And then another one we did was with Terry Brown and Crownlands was Maya Pan. And the chorus section I call the Jimmy Page section. See you, Claudio. We had Glad to hear that, Claudia. And then I had this other tune that I kind of wrote on the loud, but or maybe I wrote on the double neck, but either way, it's called Mirror Twin, and it's on Isolated Guitar. And you'll hear the Jimmy Page in this one. Thank you. Thanks for listening to that one. Now, what do we got coming up? Ah. Mandalorian. Well, we're on names for the bear. You know, a big, this Jimmy Page tuning, once you learn, oh, definitely dad get. Thank you. I'll send you a picture of the skull. This is in a different key. Roots of War. I'm going to do the rain song for you because I get so many messages about the rain song. So I did this video that my friend Edward shot, I don't know, about 5, 6, 7 years ago. And a lot of people like it. I think I could have played it a lot better, but I'm gonna play it for you now, even though I played it the other night on the double neck. Kind of a different thing. Exactly. One more time. Thank you, Charles. And I'm sorry that it's an abbreviated version if that messed up your lyrics. But it's nice that you're singing along. That is an awesome tune, isn't it? Now, I'm going to just do a few little fun things in the dobro here. The 91-year-old dobro, oldest guitar I've owned. I think I had a Martin once from the 30s, but that one's from that's from 1930. Oh, I had a National from the 1930s as well, but that one's better. Okay, this is the. quite time for the big giant medley yet, but... Yeah, fun instrument, eh? Everybody's got to love that dobro. It's also the loudest instrument in the world. Kind of like an electric instrument that's not electric. That's a Starbucks French roast, I'm sorry to say. Sorry, something more exotic for you, Arizona Michelle. Oh, is that right? Yeah, Gordy's a cool guy, and he's a great, great player. Almost, I had a brief talk with Gordy many years ago about producing the second David Barrett Trio record, and I don't know, it didn't happen for some reason. I don't know why. Would have been great, though. I'm sure he would have sorted me out. So that was a little bit. You ever see that bit in, you got to watch the movie, It Might Get Loud. I'm sure most of you have seen it, but that's, there's this part where Jimmy Page is playing a little 45 of Link Wray's Rumble. He's air guitaring to it. Yes, I do have Lavazza. That was yesterday. I had Lavazza. The Perfecto? No. Intenso. Intenso. That's what it is. I say Perfecto, but it's in the Intenso. That's a very strong Lavazza. That's the winner. That was our, Adam, that was our coffee of the year, remember? At one, a couple of years back at the Guitar Summit. And what else? I've got the a new one from Pilot going as well. And I do have a little Starbucks on reserve. And I've been getting into Balzac's lately. Balzac's. I know Andy's going to comment on that. And Jimmy Page played lead guitar on something, did he not? With a Z, Balzac's with a Z. How about the speakers, Andy? And the turntable. Thank you. What's the coffee shop out west now, Michelle? Because we used to go to Starbucks way back when I was out there a lot. Is there what's the go-to coffee brand out there? Now, I'm going to do the big medley. Jimmy Page show has been fun. Yeah. Maybe I should do, you know what? I don't think I'm going to want to pick up the mandolin after the big medley. So I'm going to do a little bit of, you can't do. Kicking Horse is great. I agree, Helen. I get that whole Nestle thing. I know. You're right. You're right. Why is my mandolin rattling? Jeez. Gotta maintain these freaking guitars, man. It's always something. Yeah. So, and Kicking Horse is great, eh? Huh? Hey, Michelle? There we go. You could go insane looking after guitars. Now, let's see. We're going to have fun. Me seeing if I can remember all these riffs. All these riffs you're going to hear are some of the first things I learned how to play on guitar. And the thing is, I don't really play them that great. I still play them like an 11-year-old. But it's fun. So many guys play covers well. Steve Thorpe sent me some recordings of his band doing Styx and Foreigner. Sounded great. Especially those Foreigner tunes, I gotta tell you. They're great. Yeah, so here we go. The big medley. But it's going to be short because really a lot of them are just the riffs. And we're going to have fun doing it. This can't go on. I'm already insane. Okay. So, yeah, check out Redbubble, everybody. The story is that the band Crucial Todd, you know, I told you about that. That was the name of our first band in high school. And Mike Myers came down to listen to us because he was auditioning us for the high school down the street to play one of their Battle of the Bands or something like that. And we got in this big argument about music. And he was saying that Led Zeppelin was over. They had their time and now it's gone. Now it's the new bands like XTC and Elvis Costello, things like that. And I disagreed. I said, no, man, Led Zeppelin's where it's at. And... So anyway, years later, when they went to make the movie, what's it called, Wayne's World, he called my bass player, Scott, my old bass player, and said, hey, I want to use that name of the band in the movie. So, you know, many years went by and came out and all that. Tia Carrere was in the band in the movie, not me. And that is the... That is a story of the Crucial Taunt thing. And so for Scott's 40th birthday, my buddy designed a Crucial Taunt logo, kind of like a Spinal Tap looking heavy metal logo that said Crucial Taunt World Tour 1980. And so I found one of my old computers and I dug up the logo and sent it to my niece to kind of clean up and change the color red, so it's now red on black, and you can buy it at Redbubble, so you can get a Crucial Taunt shirt. And I think Scott's probably already ordered one now. So, yeah. Exactly, Steve. Yeah, now you know where I'm going with that, right? So that's the deal. So we've got that, and we've got the new DBT logo as well. So, which was designed by my niece. So I'm really happy with that. That's a lot of fun. So it's fun stuff, and thank you guys for checking out the page and ordering that Redbubble stuff. And thanks for the PayPal donations. And here we go. So, I started young, Helen. I started my first band. I started playing when I was 11. I had a guitar before that, but I really started playing every day when I was 11. I learned a lot of these riffs. And by the time I was 12, I got an electric guitar, and then we kind of took the amp down the street and had this Telecaster, and we started playing in bands before you know it. I mean, we just started right away, so I was super young. I was like 12, and we had a lot of great times playing in the basements. And then you know, a few local high schools and stuff. All the same material you're hearing now, you know? Long time ago. So here we go. that one's in a different tuning, but we're going to keep going with... too much. Hey, Michelle, Toronto Michelle, see you later. Thank you. that's winging it. Okay, that was fun. I didn't really intend on trying to acoustically butcher the solo, but we're just having fun here, and that is now. Let me see. Let me put on this capo and get this guitar ready for a little salt water. We'll close out with that. Thank you so much for listening. Next week and next Sunday, I'm going to do kind of in keeping with some of this. Like last week was Sunday was acoustic Rush. This was acoustic Jimmy Page, Zeppelin, a little bit of Firm, you know, a little bit of Robert Plant, a little bit of Link Wray, and going to be the Tales from Topographic Oceans next Sunday, which will be acoustic Steve Howe and Yes. Thank you, Terry Lynn. Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Helen. Let me see if I have a nervous breakdown here. Oh my God, it's like, it's my worst nightmare. Now I'm forcing myself to do this. You know, I think we're going to call it a day. I'm going to play Mood for a Day and get ready for next week. And sometimes you gotta let things go. Thank you. Okay, just a little bit of foreshadowing for next week. And I will be back on Wednesday at 8 o'clock, of course. And what can I tell you? What am I doing Wednesday? I am doing... Oh, I think it's the FX episode. So contrasting to the acoustic, lots of effects. So thank you, everybody. And we'll see you Wednesday. Have a great rest of the weekend.